Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Last Line of Defense. In the last episode, we continued with our assault of the alien base, and despite the large amount of alien units, successfully dispatched them with no additional problems. However, Dr. Varlan believed that this was not the end, and further examination of the alien beacon began. During this, Davis was once again sent to deal with Exalt, and the team followed close behind. The ensuing mission was a clean sweep, with only our newest recruit Kebe taking damage. Now, the team await new orders from their commander. Dear Mother, I have finally been given permission to inform you that last week, my team and I successfully completed an operation targeting a hidden alien facility in Northern Europe. You should also know that no one was hurt in this, and that Major Azel believes we should be home before Christmas. I know this is still a few months away, but as you may have heard, the terrorist group Exalt continues to elude us. I hope that you are keeping well, and that both my sisters are behaving in my absence. I love you all. Miguel. Welcome back to Xcom Last Line of Defense. As we begin this episode, we research some ghost armor, and then we don't bother to do more research because I believe we're at capacity anyway. We can't research anything else. We then get a bunch of money, and I mean a bunch. We got like 800. It's pretty ridiculous. I just click on the archives for no reason. I think that's because actually, yeah, no, we can't research anything else. But we can now do some gene modding. Finally, it's taken this long for us to get that much, but we're going to fully upgrade Endo, and we're going to go in this weird zigzag pattern because I have thought about what I wanted, and it kind of just goes really quickly without actually going through what I want, so I guess we'll see eventually. We're going to upgrade all of our stuff. We're going to get new gene soldier. We're going to upgrade to a Mech 3 Paladin, which is just insane. I think that gives her a grenade launcher. But either way, we've upgraded vastly, and now we can also build a bunch of shit with the remaining money. We've got so much lyrium and so many alloys. This is not going to be a problem. We're finally possibly going to build a particle cannon. Please say I build the particle cannon right now. I probably don't know. I've built the plasma rifle, sniper rifle, which, to be fair, isn't the worst purchase. It just means I still don't have a particle cannon after all this time. Also, we're going to build an alloy cannon, which is the shotgun upgrade. So we now have pretty much all of the upgraded weapons as well. I think we're just missing like the plasma rifle. Also just looking around at things so that we can load people out appropriately, giving Basso her alloy cannon, which is just an insane gun with a ridiculous amount of critical damage. And it's just better because 8 to 10 damage is just insane. It's just a great weapon, basically. We still need to purchase quite a few other things, such as squad upgrades. Tactical rigging is the one that we really need as well. And Endo has 15 days in the genetics lab. We're not going to do anything for her, which means if we get a mission in the next 15 days, we won't be able to take Endo, which is a very interesting thing, since Endo has pretty much been in every single mission for a very long time. We also built a bunch of satellites, which is great because that means we're going to be able to get a load of extra. We've got 4 available, and we have something like 3 possible stuff. So we're going to finish Asia, which gives us an incredible amount of things. And we're also going to get Canada. So we need to build one more uplink so that we can get 2 more slots, so we can put one in Egypt and Mexico. But pretty much we're just making nearly 1,000 a month now. It's very, very ridiculous, but it's awesome at the same time. So going back to mission controls, we've got a sonic lab as well, which is about to be built. But before that, we get Exalt going back to be a bitch in Australia. So we're going to send Davis once again to go towards Exalt. No alien activity as such yet, which is pretty good for us, but I'm wondering what they possibly could be up to and what happens really after you destroy the facility, because we know it's not the end of it. After a little quick autosave, or a save on my behalf, we build the Sonic Labs finally, which is going to allow us to build Psy soldiers or test for Psy ability. Also get a bunch of rebate for that as well, which is great. We've got 100. Could see if we can build anything else. We're probably just going to excavate stuff or build a facility, but we don't really have enough. I want to build a thermal power generator there, since this has steam. So yes, but I don't think. Yeah, I think we might just be saving money for the now. And the foundry are just going to look around at what we can build, Apparently an improved medkit, which I believe we are going to build because it's pretty good. I think that just is, I think it's not improved medkit, it's just upgrades medkit to be improved. There's also a bunch of shiv and improved pistol stuff. So there we go, that's all done for now. Even though in this game you don't really use pistols that often. Only really the snipers do. And then the counselor has a mission for us, which is fantastic. So we're going to launch. It actually gives us a bunch of awesome stuff, such as panic reduction. But this is a good team we're going to take. I've accelerated this a bit. As you can see, we've got Yang and Kebe with us. And we're going to Operation Devil's Mist.
Hostiles converging on the area. We need you to confirm Mr. Van Dorn is still alive and bring him back safe before the whole place is overrun. We have a new objective.
Hey, friendlies over here.
So in this mission we have to escort this VIP, so basically we just have to go next to him, and then after that we need to escort him back to the Sky Ranger, I believe, something like that. Or that guy isn't the general, that guy's just part of his platoon. I think that's what it is, that guy's part of General Van Dorn's platoon, and then he's going to tell us where General is. It's like, the general's over there, you have to go get him before he gets killed. It's like, alright, cool. So what we're going to be doing is basically just that. We're going to be going across this bridge, which they happen to be upon, and going to try and rescue General Van Dorn. So what we're going to do is basically what we always do with missions. We're going to split up the team around the place. Spots are those a Finmen. These are really weak. Like, at this point in the game, Finmen are pretty just redundant and probably shouldn't even bother. They're just a waste of ammo at this point. But yeah, and we're going to be taking all of our new troopers along with us. So that's happening. Kebe and Yang ready to go forth and assault everyone. Yang has got, basically Yang has just taken Endo's equipment, basically. She's got the new plasma rifle, she's got the new plasma sniper rifle, sorry. She's also got a really cool Archangel armor, and she's gone purple because I've edited it to be like that, because customization is a thing. The Thin Man tries to hit Vargas and totally misses, as well as just go into Overwatch. So what we're going to do is we're going to move Kebe up, probably get hit by an Overwatch because obviously he's an Overwatch. He's going to fire, he's going to miss because it's a Thin Man, they're not exceptionally any good. And then she's going to try and shoot, but she doesn't get a really good, like, she gets 54%, that's good enough, I guess. Yeah, well, I mean, it's good enough. She kills that Thin Man, so there we go, with a critical hit as well. Gonna move the team up continuously. We do have Guzman very far ahead with her new Mark III suit. She's got a ton of health now, I think she's got something like 24. There's a lot. She's then going to kill that Thin Man over there, leaving only one left with another critical hit. That's two critical hits in two shots, that's pretty insane. Yang is going to run up. Now, Yang has been specced very differently to Endo. Yang is a close range sniper. She can shoot her sniper on the turn that she moves, I believe. I might be completely wrong. But yeah, and Basso is going to move up as well. She could probably run and gun, but I'm going to choose not to. I'd like to note that Basso has 22 health, and she's just like wearing normal Titan armor, whilst Guzman has 24 and she's wearing a whole mech suit. It's very strange that it's gone that way. So yeah, no comment on that. Guzman is going to keep moving up. She's going to move through the toxic gas, but she's immune, of course, being in armor. In fact, she doesn't actually. Oh my god, there's more Thin Men, just a bunch of Thin Men in this episode. Then again, kind of makes sense that there's only Thin Men. I'm not entirely sure if there'll be more. Electropulse. Oh, she didn't get the rock. No, she got the rocket launcher before, so the Electropulse is the thing that upgrade. Now, the Electropulse is a pretty cool thing. You'll see it most likely later. That grenade was insane, killing all three of them in one shot. Can't remember what I said. Yeah, no, it makes sense that the aliens are, at the moment, just Thin Men, because they're the, basically, just the infiltrators, because we've destroyed the alien facility, so makes sense. Basso's going to run over there, it's all good. Vargas is then going to do that. I would like to note as well that Titan armor makes you immune to poison gas. So, yes, I'm pretty sure we could just run through it. I might be wrong though, but I'm pretty sure it does make you immune. Cinnamon's going to move up as well. And then Yang's going to do something similar. Most likely. I mean, Yang could possibly just go into Overwatch where she is, or just move up slightly and then go into Overwatch. I can't exactly remember how I spec'd her, because last time we used her, and I checked, this was like mission 18, and we're on like mission 30 something. Which I'm going to double check whilst she just chooses what the fuck to do. Yang. No, even before then. Alright, wow. Oh, apparently somewhere, yeah, mission 17. Damn, son. So things have just happened in the background. I think that was the general who's being targeted by something, or is just around the stuff. Well, we found him anyway, so we can go close to him and then escort him back to the Sky Ranger. It's not going to be too bad. Vaso is just going to run and gun it so that she can go right next to him straight away. In so doing, she's going to spot a new set of thin men. One of them is going to Overwatch, but she's got lightning reflexes, meaning that she can't actually be at Overwatch, and it also gives her a good flanking shot. Since she's run and gun, she can still fire. We have, however, there's a bunch of enemies here, it's ridiculous. So she's going to get the flanking shot on that Finman with her alloy cannon, which is just insane. Whilst the rest of everyone else is just saying, "Oh yes, do this, go here. Please, please." So Yang does have squad sight. Okay, so she's not, or do they automatically get squad sight? I can't remember. Either way, she's just shot and killed that first thin man. She doesn't get double tap though, so that's pretty good. Peter Van Dorn, or General Van Dorn as we like to call him, is going to go there. He's also going to get poisoned because I just ran him through the poison, so he's going to have to get healed at some point, which is really irritating. So Vargas is going to have to escort him along. Guzman is going to step on top of that next to the ladder so that she doesn't block the ladder way. Sees a thin man, is going to fire from this direction over there. She shoots, missing the thin man. It is on the other side of the bridge though, so you can't really say that, you know, it was a terrible shot, because it was a terrible shot to begin with. However, it was a 65%, so you know. Kebe is going to go around there just to make sure that if anything comes behind us, something is going to shoot them. Suleiman is going to take cover here so that he can give covering fire should anything appear. So he's going to go into Overwatch, and then Vargas is going to go next to the general so that he can heal him next turn. In fact, I'm probably going to just put him ahead so that he can do that next turn when the general just keeps moving up, so that we don't slow down the progress. Thin men are going to come forward and then going to get hit by Suleiman, who misses his Overwatch, as is the huge. With Overwatch shots from our heavy for some reason. He's going to continue his movement down, and then he's going to try and fire at Guzman, missing the massive target, which is interesting. And then another thin man's going to come across and try and fire at Basso, actually hitting with 3 damage. But it's okay, she's got 24 health. 22, sorry. So yeah, whatever. The other thin man's going to move up and also try his luck. Yep, he's going to try and hit Guzman, missing again. I believe that's because Guzman is on high elevation, so she gets a bonus in defense. We also get, as I thought, some thin men just appearing out behind us. Luckily, Kebe is there to take care of that. Vargas also managing to do that, but there we go. As we can see, the general is still poisoned. Kebe is going to fire at the other thin man with 82%, killing him outright. Doing a really good job of clearing the back. Yang is going to use her sniper for 51% chance of killing that guy. Firing and missing. I mean, that was a practically a 50-50 shot. In fact, it was a 51-49 shot. So Peter is going to allow us to move him, thank you very much, into cover, and then Vargas is going to go next to him to heal him before we forget to do so. Go across, going to heal him. We got so many medkits, we might as well use them. Can heal 8 HP now because of these medkits instead of, I believe, the usual 6. I might be mistaken though, I'm not sure. Either way, Guzman is going to fire another grenade. She's got a bonus grenade now, so she's going to fire that and kill those two very quickly. There we go, both those die. There's only one left. She could, well, Suleiman could fire a rocket at him. I believe that is an option. Or Basso could just fire with 7% chance because of how far she is from everything. Now it's up to 39. She's going to try anyway. Fires actually manages to kill him despite the low chance of success. Gonna go into Overwatch, and then we've got more alien activity coming on. Cars exploding. It doesn't seem to be any more aliens coming through. Oh yes, there is one that's just come from over there. And another one from there. Basso is going to have to deal with that one. And then another one from there, which will probably be taken care of by Kebe. Cinnamon actually takes care of that one. Wow, he actually hit with Overwatch. That's insane. So there we go. Now, continuing our progress. Kebe is going to go around to this car so that she can hit the flanked Thin Man, killing him outright straight away. Yang also has a shot, 71% chance to hit, might as well take it. She fires, missing on 71%. She's no endo, that's for sure. Vargas is going to have to take care of him instead. He's going to go around. Actually gets hit by a Overwatch shot because, you know, why not? It doesn't get hit, actually it's a miss, but gets shot at because of Overwatch. Vargas is then going to have to be able to be flanking that guy with 90% chance to hit. Fires, hits, and getting rid of that problem. So next, the general is going to move, dash up to cover that car. Then Guzman, or Suleiman, is probably just going to overwatch where he is. Or is he going to move down? Not entirely sure. Basso's going to have to do something. Probably move back. Yeah, she's going to move back to the back of this truck, going into Overwatch. I think the rest of them are going to go into Overwatch as well, making sure that no one else can go there or surprise them from here. During the inactivity, nothing really happens. No more Thin Men appear, so we're just going to put Von Damme, whatever. He goes in the Sky Ranger and we win the battle. It's very basic win-win, let's go home kind of thing. As we fly across the Pacific, we're going to see what kind of promotions we've earned through this mission. Of course, landing first. Well, that was a pretty easy thing. We got, actually got stuff. So Basso finally leveled up, became a colonel. She got herself either killing Singslaxer to get run and gun and gain 50% critical, or resistance, meaning immunity to critical hits. Kebe is going to become a corporal, given her either tactical sense or aggression. I'm just going to decide to possibly take aggression. There we go, given her bonus critical hit chance. And then Yang becomes a lieutenant. She's going to go for most likely battle scanner. I think that's what I'm going to go for. No? Really? I think I go for battle... No, alright. Who the fuck did I go battle scanner with? I remember using it at some point. Either way, we win. We got paradoxes, actually. We also get a major somehow. So we're going to continue our go. We're going to look at the foundry things we can build. Improve the arc thrower. We can build armor conservation, which I'm not entirely sure what that does. Probably just grants us more ammo, I guess. Tactical rigging. Oh, I finally get tactical rigging. Oh my god, guys. Hype. Also got mech host combat improvements possibilities. Scope upgrades, stealth satellites. Everything is sexy. So yeah, it's all good. There's a lot of possible stuff we can build. We got to the point where we've got so much money now every time we do that. We do go for ammo conservation. Tactical rigging is great. It allows us to... Oh, we actually have to level those up. And then something weird happens.
What the hell?
Sir! Internal systems are shutting down all over HQ!
This is Central. Security status red. Repeat. What have you done? Answer me!
Sir, we're picking up movement near the outer perimeter. Multiple sensors have been tripped. We have a breach.
Thank you.
Quickly! Man the defenses! Rouse the operatives! We cannot let them through! Forn? We need to ready the defenses. Where are you? Commander, you must lead the troops on the ground. I'll stay here with Bradford and try to get the rest of them to you. Hold the line. They shall not pass.
Delta section, report. Delta section, report. Finally. Delta section. It looks like your emergency generators are back online. And oh, Delta, whatever this attack is, you're right in the crosshairs. We've got perimeter alerts triggering from all sides. It looks like you've got flyers coming through the cavern near the rear guard station. Plus, you've got a whole wall of heat signatures coming down through the vents in the ceiling above you. Whoever breached our internal security locked down the door system, separating you from the rest of the base. Once we get the doors open again, we can start sending reinforcements through, but that might take some time. Right now, it looks like the closest alarms being triggered are in the vents above you. Keep an eye out for any indications of movement. Delta Section, you have to hold the line. The future of XCOM is counting on you.
So, here we are in a mission of defense. We have only a few operatives with us. Luckily enough, we have Vargas, Guzman, and I believe Suleiman on the right side. So we have good enough operatives, but also on top you may see some individual stat line people. Those are our rookies who have been put in the front line, despite definitely not being ready for it. So we're going to have to do a defense. We know that there are going to be flyers coming in from the left side, but for the first time we're going to be doing just a very quick overwatch everywhere. We have to get to this position here, and we're going to have to do that fast. Luckily, Guzman has been fully upgraded, and she has an amazing electro pulse, which will come in handy against flyers, which of course are cyber discs. And as you can see, we've got some bunch of really poorly equipped rookies just standing there. And here come the first.
Don't give them one inch of our soil.
We've got a mechtoid there, we've got a sectoid commander there. That mechtoid is completely destroyed. That there's a muton that comes in. There's a chrysalid that comes in. There's another chrysalid that comes in. We are getting assaulted from all sides. And another muton. Never ending. And another mechtoid. Luckily, Suleiman takes care of that one. But luckily, we have some protection. Basso comes running through the gate, and we're going to start killing some dudes as fast as possible. We've already started. We've killed a muton and a mechtoid already. We're going to have to pick our targets very carefully. Luckily, we have some big hitters with us. Having four of our A team with us is just fantastic, especially Basso. She's going to deal a lot of damage with her alloy cannon and her rapid fire. And better not underestimate these squaddies, although, or the rookies I should say, the rookies aren't terrible. They have terrible weaponry, but they can still deal damage. So we're going to try and kill that sectoid commander, managing to do so with a critical hit of 13. Flores, one of our rookies, just going to move to the side and go into overwatch most likely, unless he's going to go for a shot at that mechtoid. 55% chance, I mean, why not, you know? Fires, deals 3 damage. Great shot, mate. Sydney Martz, nice, is also going to do a similar thing. Might just go on Overwatch, actually. He does have a grenade. That's another thing that's really good about these rookies. They all have grenades. Another 55% chance, and another 2 damage. There's a go. That's one health bar gone. Vargas has been flanked all over, and Guzman also has the ability to take care of this muton. She's going to go through that window, and is going to punch this guy through the wall. That'll teach him to try and bugger up our things. There we go, punching through the wall, 12 damage, muton down. We've taken quite a few of them out now. There's two chrysalids still around, as well as this mechtoids. So the chrysalid is probably going to be one of our biggest enemies here, but the mechtoid is, of course, a really big threat. It can deal a lot of damage. Medina has been flanked, so she's going to have to go around this side. However, she does get a good shot upon this one, and 4 damage dealt. So all the rookies have focused on that mechtoid, dealing quite a bit of damage to him. Not a huge amount, but enough. And then Vargas is going to try and hit, dealing 8 damage. leaving him on one hit point. Cinnamon is going to move slightly farther up. He's going to have to try and hit 65, managing to kill the Mechtoids with a 10 damage. Probably should have let Vargas do something else and hit with Cinnamon first. But hey, you live and you learn. During the alien activity, the Chrysalids are going to start their movements, as one of our rookies can sense. Chrysalid goes through the door, doesn't have enough to actually do any kind of combat, gets right in the way of Guzman, and then the other Chrysalid jumps down, goes towards Suleiman, or Vargas, goes towards Vargas in fact. But both of them had to dash, so they couldn't do anything, and luckily there are no more alien reinforcements for the time being. So Vargas is right next to a Chrysalid, probably just needs to shoot it, to be honest. Doesn't really need to do anything there, and Guzman is probably just going to punch this one again. Luckily, kinetic strike can be done every turn. There we go. Muton and Chrysalid's corpse just mutilated within each other. And Vasa could probably run around and kill that. Or all the rookies could shoot it. That's also a possibility with 75% chance to hit. She fires and misses. Well done. Medina also has a shot. Going to get herself into a good position as well. 75% chance to hit again. Fires and hits for 4 damage. Basso is going to let Flores and Martz take these shots. Going for the Chrysalid. 65% chance only. Not enough, doing another miss. You can really see the difference between an elite member of the XCOM and one of the rookies that I never use. 55% chance actually hits for 2 damage, which is pretty good. However, we have no more rookies that can fire it, so we're going to have to waste a shot doing something. Basso is probably going to be that person. She's going to go around the side. She actually does have a arc thrower, but she's not in range with it. She's just going to use her pistol. That's not a bad choice, actually. We have pistols, might as well use them. Laser pistoling that to death, allowing both Suleiman and Vargas to have extra things to do. So Vargas is going to go around the side, go into Overwatch, and Suleiman's going to reload. And that will end his turn. Once again, no alien threat detected now. They are still coming in, of course, but no additional reinforcements have been sighted, which is very good. We're going to move Guzman up to the opening here so that she can go into Overwatch. Thomas is going to reload. Medina is going to reload. Basso is going to most likely go into a position of cover and go into Overwatch where she is with her laser pistol, because I fucked that up. Flores is going to reload, and Martez is going to reload. Martez is going to reload, I should say. And here comes the airborne movements. Got a reaction shot from Guzman, who fires and, I believe, misses the cyber disc. And we have a bunch of cyber discs comes in now. So the first cyber disc goes around here. Got another cyber disc that comes around.
Could there be any more cyber discs?
Just a bunch of cyber discs, and actually just running through that, and then another. No, that's there. It's a drone. So we've got drones, we've got cyber discs, just all the airborne. I forgot about the drones, actually. I'm not going to lie. So we have a bunch of reserve. There's another cyber disc. There's 3 cyber discs coming around them, flanking. That's it's just a lot of danger going on. And another cyber disc. There's a 4th one. That one's also going to go up above. And at this point, I'm probably just wondering what the fuck is going on. But hey, we're going to have to do something about that, don't we? So we decide to move up Vargas, who's going to see a bunch of cyber discs. In fact, he's not going to see any of them. He's going to go into Overwatch. He could do a smoke grenade, that would be insane. And just give defense to one person, because Guzman is obviously going to move up next time. Like during her turn. What a poorly placed smoke grenade. Anyway, Suleiman doesn't have a shot on anything. He does have a rocket launcher, which I don't believe I'm going to be using, but it's an option. I do look to see the range, but the range doesn't get very far. It only goes up to Guzman. It could be very useful, though, in later, should they come any closer. So we're just going to stick him most likely closer up to the to this side, put him in into Overwatch, or just put him into Overwatch here. There's a lot of things that going through my head right now. This is a very desperate situation. We have Electropulse, which we are going to be using, and it's going to do an insane amount of damage to all of these people. Look at that. This is going to hit so many of them. Electropulse done. And there we go. Dealing 5 damage to every single robot there. And also disabling
If you make it out of this, I'm going to kiss you for that shot.
Thomas is going to look up to see what's just happened. All of these cyber discs have been taken out. There is a drone, however. The drone up top hasn't been destroyed. Dealing 3 damage to that cyber disc, who, because of being disabled, I think loses a lot of defensive bonus. Medina is going to move up, going into Overwatch where she is. Basso is going to run and gun as close as possible to the action to try and deal with this. She's going to go to the edge of the door, which gives her full cover, which is fantastic, and also being able to target some of these cyber discs, 82% and 64. That must have been 82 then. The rapid fire laser pistol, because I haven't changed weapon yet. Thank you. So now we've got some really, really good shots. Potential of rapid fire, 71%. Gonna fire first and a second. Missing the second one, but hitting for 10 damage with one of them, which is pretty good. Flores is going to move up and go into Overwatch. I'm hoping that the cyber discs are the only enemy that's going to show up and there's not going to be any reinforcements from the ceiling, but the danger is ever present. So we're just going to put everyone in Overwatch and then the aliens get their turn. Of course, all the cyber discs have been disabled. There is just one drone. I think one of the drones actually got killed as well. Thomas gets hit by that drone, only dealing 3 damage though, so Thomas should be fine for now, but she has taken a hit. Vargas is going to go around the side. He only spots one enemy, but it's more than enough. He can just take him out with a shot. Luckily, he doesn't miss that one. That would have been really embarrassing if he had done. It explodes, dealing no damage to anyone, really. Suleiman is going to stay in Overwatch. Guzman doesn't have her electromagnetics pulse for another 2 turns, but that shouldn't be too much of a problem. She's going to go next to that cyberdisc and going to punch it to death, dealing 12 damage to it, which is more than enough to wreck it completely. Does explode, dealing 3 damage to Guzman, but it's more than it's just a small amount of damage. 73% chance to kill that drone, or you hit that drone and misses. So Thomas most likely not going to make it past this shot. And then we're going to go into Overwatch with our other rookie. Basso is going to go outside. She's going to try and get a shot on these, but she doesn't, which is very irritating. So she's just going to take this time to reload. They are still disabled by EMP, I believe, for one more turn. So we should be fine for now. Another Overwatch from one of our operatives, and then Marz is also going to get another Overwatch off just in case anything does fly down, but I don't believe that will be an option. And then the drone finally takes out Thomas with a shot.
This is why we need more funding.
Our first death of this. The cyberdiscs actually do move up and then shoot at Basso, dealing 9 damage, so it doesn't have the MP, only does it for one turn, which is a bit irritating. And then that cyberdisc is also going to target Basso, so she's taken 9 damage already, and now she's taken another 9, that's 18 damage. She's very heavily damaged, which is awful. However, Central believes that the game is not lost yet. Luckily, Vargas is nearby, can heal her wound so she can take one more shot, so she'll be shot again. Either way, we need to be much more careful with that. Suleiman still staying where he is. He actually is going to move up this time. Try and get himself into a position. However, I'm still worried that there's going to be reinforcements that come down from the ceiling at some point. Guzman is going to move up. She does have a jump bot module so that she can just jump up, which is going to help her get very close to this cyberdisc. She jumps, goes up. There's a bunch of cyberdiscs. She's going to kinetic strike this one. It will be able to kill him actually, so that's always good. Punches it, and it explodes far away from either of them, so it's not going to deal any damage. Medina's going to move up to see where Thomas is. Spots the drone. Oh no, that's just one of the cyberdiscs. She fires at it and actually hits with that very low chance of damage. Actually hitting. So that's always good. Basso is going to take her turn next. She's going to move up and try and kill that drone, or the cyber disc, one or the other. I'm not 100% sure which one it is. I believe it's going to be the drone because she can't see the cyber disc. But 90% chance, and it has killed something, so you know. Killing the drone, 10 damage. Very, very good. Flores is going to probably stay where he is, or is he going to move up? I think he's probably going to stay where he is. Doesn't particularly want to get one shot by a Cyberdisc. I'm sure no one wants to get one shot by a Cyberdisc, to be honest. But it looks like I'm trying to make him dash as close as possible to that threat, which might not be the best idea. Probably just going to go into Overwatch where he is, or to cover next to Silliman, or just aim a frag grenade at himself. I mean, that's also an option. Just goes into Overwatch, and now we get more alien activity. As you can see, we've got reinforcements coming in. This Cyberdisc does the spin attack. I think that's probably an AI glitch to have done that there, because obviously it only hits on a vertical stage, so because no one was next to it, it wasn't going to take any damage. We got a sectoid, a chrysalid, another sectoid, got a bunch of aliens coming in through the other room, another sectoid going in there. Luckily it wasn't that many stuff, and then the game crashed. So carrying on, Vasa is going to move up next to this Cyberdisc, and then she's going to try and push onto it. 100% chance to do 10 damage.
That shiny new armor didn't do you much good.
Outright. It explodes, dealing 3 damage to Vasa. I think that was more than 3 actually. So Vargas is going to have to heal her ASAP. Flores is going to move up, sees one of the what the hell was that? That didn't look like a sectoid. Oh well, goes into Overwatch. Xiao has just appeared. Xiao coming through the doors. He, however, has no equipment because of the way this game works and the fact that I've only made a certain amount of armor to fit the A-team. Xiao doesn't get any equipment. He's got his shitty little armor with his shitty little weapon. This is why after this I've realized that maybe I should just give everyone laser equipment from the that we pick up from the Exalt, just because if that happens again, if I have to use my rookies, then it would be bad. Guzman moves up. She doesn't get target anymore, but she goes into Overwatch where she is, or does she reload? No, goes into Overwatch. Medina is also going to go into Overwatch where she is, allowing for the aliens to do their movement. Suleiman senses the movement coming through, and we spot a sectoid going in, which Xiao is going to fire at, but he misses. It's very irritating that he's got a very shitty weapon. Like, considering I've got a bunch of laser weapons in the back, it would be nice if they could just pick those up. This guy gives a... oh, it's a chrysid, that's what it was. Gives a... the sectoid buffs up a other alien. This chrysalid comes through, gets shot by Flores, doesn't do any damage. Then Suleiman's going to go up and actually kill him for none damage, eliminating that threat. And then we've got the buffed up sectoid over there who's going to try and shoot at... actually suppressing one of our rookies. Probably not one of the best things to do. Vargas is going to move into cover. He's going to try and get a good shot off, but he can't, so he's just going to go into Overwatch. Suleiman is going to go around the side. Of course, he knows that if he kills that guy over there, he's just going to get that. So he's just going to throw a needle grenade around the back here. He's going to try and get a good shot off, good angle, so that he can't get hit. But he can still hit the sectoid giving the buff, so he's just going to do that, throwing a needle grenade around the corner, killing that sectoid and killing the other one as well with the backlash. But apparently, wasn't enough. Or was it? Nope, still going. This is very strange. Obviously, the sectoid that he just hit didn't have a good enough, or had way more health than he was expecting, which can only mean it was a sectoid commander and not an actual sectoid. Guzman has to go up and kill it with a grenade. Medina is going to move slightly up ahead and go into Overwatch. Basso needs to get healed by Vargas ASAP, so she's going to go into full cover, going to reload her alloy cannon, hopefully. If not, then oh well. Yeah, she does go into a reload, and Flores is going to move up as well. And go into Overwatch where he is. Martz is going to go into Overwatch. Xiao is going to move up into full cover there. He actually does get a spot upon the alien commander, or the sectoid commander, or the heavy sectoid, or whatever it's called. He's going to use his suppression ability, which is very useful to have. During the alien turn, the sectoid tries to shoot back a Xiao. Oh no, he does a little mind thing. Tries to mind control it, but luckily it has failed. And there we go. No more additional contacts in the command center itself, which means that we can now push. We can do our counterattack and push the aliens out of our system, out of our area. Basso is going to move next to Vargas, so Vargas doesn't have to move. She's going to go into Overwatch. Suleiman is going to go next to here. Spot what there is, and he just flanks the commander and then going to put a shot into him, or several shots I should say, killing the commander outright. There we go. So now it all seems good. I think there might be a chrysalid still out there somewhere, but Guzman is going to go around and go into Overwatch where she is. Medina is going to go in Overwatch where she is. Flores is going to move up to where Suleiman was so that she can go into, he can go into Overwatch. Marth is going to go into Overwatch, and Xiao is going to move up and go into Overwatch. Vargas is then going to heal Basso. She's probably going to do that twice. She's going to do that this first time and then again most likely afterwards. Doesn't get any more stuff. During the alien activity, nothing happens. We don't see any more, we don't notice any more reinforcements coming in. Basso, missing 5 HP, but I think that might be enough. Like, she probably should get healed again, but we don't know how that might go. So she's just going to back off, going to Overwatch. And Flores is going to move up. I don't think at this point I've realized that the aliens aren't going to come through here anymore. So I'm just putting everyone in Overwatch, waiting for another round. Going to reload everyone. There's no real time limit, it's just the amount of reinforcement that comes in just continues.
I'm on it, Commander.
Even though I've just looked actually on the left side of the objectives, it says latest wave, enemy wave in mech bay, so I should probably go to the mech bay. But yeah. So there we go, so thank God Central tells me that there is something moving there, so I'm going to actually move up to do that. And we can see one of the sectoids going around. He's going to try and do a shooty shoot at one of our rookies, but misses due to the distance. We've also got another thing going in. There we go, another sectoid coming in as reinforcements. We've then got another sectoid coming in. And another sectoid, just a bunch of sectoids coming in. This must be a kind of group wave. And then we've got a mechtoid up there. And another mechtoid up there. And another mechtoid up there. And a sector commander here. There we go, a bunch of new troops. So we're going to definitely have to move. At this point, no matter if I was confused whether or not they would reinforce here, they haven't. They're reinforcing the mech bay, so we're probably going to have to do something about that ASAP. Suleiman is going to move up to a position where he can get better cover, but I can't actually see what that is. So he's actually going to go up here, which gives him an even higher elevation. But he is going to most likely... Oh, he's not going to get a watch. Okay, good. But he does spot a bunch of dudes, which is awful. So he's going to try and take out some of these sectoids, shooting that one, 95% chance, successfully doing so from his very high elevation. Guzman is going to then move up. She's got her electromagnetic pulse back just in case mechtoids come rushing all around. She's going to go into Overwatch where she is. Medina has the possibility of just rushing out to this location here, so that's what she's going to do. She doesn't get to go into Overwatch where she is though for doing that. Basso is just going to run up as she can. She could go around there. Is that really why I decided to do that? It's a really long convoluted way of going up to that side. Probably should have just run past, but she's going to go up there apparently. Flores is going to move or tentatively up, or fire a grenade. Yeah, he's going to fire a grenade up down there. Throwing that grenade and boom, there goes that sectoid. Next, Martz is going to finally move from her or his position. No, he's going to let Xiao do his action first. Going into Overwatch. Is Mart Sydney? So Sydney could be a name of a guy. It is a guy, alright, cool. Sydney could be a guy or a girl, so I got confused. Right, just goes there. And then the alien activity ensues. You can see some sectoid stuff going on. Shout out to Shot.
Why do we hire you if you can't even make that shot?
Pretty good cover for the sectoid there, though, so wasn't expecting it to hit, to be honest. Tries to shoot at Suleiman. Successfully missing there. So there we go. We know that there's a mechtoid there. Oh, holy crap. He's going to move up. Going to get hit by an overwatch from Guzman. Hits for 6 damage. He really needs a particle cannon. Like, really bad. I'm really annoyed that I keep forgetting to make those. And then it's going to fire at someone. No, it's going to get buffed by a sectoid. Luckily, it doesn't do anything more, which is very good. Bug is going to move up to the side. Suleiman has got 2 nice shots at stuff. He's going to wait until one of the rookies, which we're going to basically be using as scouts, spots one of the enemy alien sectoids buffing up so we can kill them all. Moves up to a really nice position where you can spot everyone, which is great. Martz is going to move up to the second floor so that he can get a nice elevation position next to Medina. Xiao is going to not do anything where he is. Going to let Suleiman let it rip. Suleiman doesn't actually get any good shots against anyone, but he does have a rocket launcher. So he's going to try and hit as many as possible. He's got a good hit on all 3 of those, so he's going to finally use his rocket in probably the best way possible. Firing there, killing 2 of the sectoid and really heavily damaging another. He doesn't get any other shots, of course. Basso is going to sprint up to cover and also to that side. She's really in a bad position, so that's not always good for that. Xiao is then going to move up. Possibility of a smoke grenade, or that's going to be really helpful. He's going to try and take out the sectoid there. 65%. Does he get the kill? Yes, he does, which deals bonus damage to the mechtoid. And now Suleiman's got a really good shot at him. Of course, Suleiman can't do anything. But Guzman can, and she's going to move up and punch this guy right in the noggin. Oh, dealing a really nice brutalized hit. Completely ripping this guy apart. Well done, Guzman. Medina is then going to go to the corner there. No, she's not. She's going to go into Overwatch. Interesting. The alien activity then proves that it is not all over, as we got some more movement coming up. I think there's still one sectoid or something. But nothing else happens. Vargas is going to move closer to the action. Bring into Overwatch. Suleiman most likely going to let Guzman do all the moving. Or we could put in a rookie up first. Yep, Flores is going up first. Being used as a scout.
On my way.
Martz is going to move up. Doesn't spot anyone where he is. He's just going to move to the corner there. Xiao is going to move up as well, down into the mech bay.
Enemy in sight.
And then spots that dude. We don't actually have any snipers, I realise. None of our reinforcements have been snipers. We've not had Yang, we've not had Endo, which is very frustrating. Suleiman is going to move up. I believe that's all our reinforcements, though. Might get another wave, potentially, but I highly doubt it. Suleiman's going to go into Overwatch where he is, and then Guzman is going to try and deal with that. There, going up. Not getting a shot on that dude, though. Then Medina is going to move to that corner. And then keep on moving as Basso moves up. Going into Overwatch. And then we get more reinforcements from the aliens. Seem to be going forward. Suleiman gets a shot. He misses, of course. That poor mechtoid. Then he gets hit by Flores, who also misses. The mechtoid must be very agile, to be honest. He's not getting hit by anyone. And then the mechtoid is going to try and shoot at Xiao, doing 8 whole damage. Xiao is on very low health now. And then reinforcements come through. We have a mechtoid over there who's going to hit by Guzman, dealing 8 damage. moving to the center of that barrier here. And reinforcements come down. A muton. A sectoid. Another mechtoid, holy crap. And a berserker. How are we going to deal with this? Find out next time.